Hey guys, welcome back. Let's do another crystal mission. It's like four in total or something.
I gathered allies, and we made our way to the forbidden archive world of Zaku. There, a triumvirate of mystic preservers awaited us. And in the shadows, something else was watching and waiting.
Look how much research you get. 3 and 3, jeez. It's like turbocharging.
Alright, Zeratulo, buddy, you got your mysterious prophecy. Now let's see what your preserver's made of it.
My quest to decipher the prophecy took me to the forbidden archive world of Zakul. Here, three immortal preservers guarded ancient knowledge. Only they could transcribe the prophetic fragments. I needed to seek them out quickly.
Wanderous. This one's a bit of a doozy, especially in the early game, but, you know, it's still not entirely difficult to pull it off. You just have to kind of act a little bit faster than normal, and you gotta strategize.
It is strangely silent here. Yet these structures are intact. With power, they would be functional.
Alrighty. Good job, probes. How does he fit all that stuff in the ship? I will never know. Alright. So, we're gonna want to bring one here, one here. And we're done with that. Whoops, I forgot to start making probes. Probes, very important. But yeah, you want to power things, you want to get some defenses up ASAP, because you're going to need every little ounce of what you got. And there's number one, and there's number two. And we start on weapons.
The mighty spirits of the preservers are imprisoned close by. We must find them.
Yeah, we must find them, I know. Alright, gonna get our first gas, and we'll get this stuff underway. It's as I said, it's a little bit of a difficult mission, because there's a big-ass hybrid that keeps coming towards you, and it's really not a whole lot of fun. Alright, first stalker, bring him down here. One second, let me just get guys on gas.
There are many abandoned structures in this place.
Actually, wait, no, bring them back.
They merely need their power restored by the construction of a few well-placed pylons.
Yeah, let this guy have his nice little speech.
The preservers you seek serve a higher power now, Dark One.
Just to make sure he doesn't go through the shields of this. I don't know if you actually need the extra firepower, but I'd like to do it anyways.
Higher power? What could have corrupted these Protoss so? Truly, something foul has taken hold of this sacred place.
It shall be.
You want to bring him back to the cannon at least.
Very well.
And now you can go do his thing. Alright, and more probes.
A dark shrine. Once power is restored, it could be of great value to us.
Very simple. It's just these two buildings. You make sure you build the pylons out of the way, though, so nothing comes after it, because...
A robotics facility. This structure may prove useful to us.
There is an illusion.
Protoss and Zerg hybrid. Gods, an abomination. Who created this atrocity?
Come, my slaves. The time has come.
Fun guy.
I'm here in the shadows.
We actually didn't go for that soon enough. I should have gone that way sooner.
Zeratul, truly fate has sent you here.
Join me, brothers, and we shall cleanse this place of evil.
Command us.
More than willing. Alright, and we have an immortal now. So we're pretty good to go.
I return to serve. My thanks, mighty one.
This knowledge is forbidden.
He is creepy as hell. Anyways, so your strategy here is that you're going to want... you're not going to really want to make any more immortals. What you are going to want to do is you're going to want to... make as many stalkers as humanly possible. That's how I did it, and that's how I won it. I pretty much kicked its ass. See, if I had the pylon out here, he'd go attack that. That's why I didn't do that. And these guys will go on their own, wait until his shields run out, make him run. Shields run out, run. He's now attacking that thing, and he's only doing like 10 damage to it. Oh, all gone. We're all done.
I shall return. Come, my slaves. The time has come to give me your strength.
The hybrid is draining the preservers to survive. I must free them before it is too late.
Yeah, we'll do that, don't worry. He cries too much. Anyways, you don't want to venture out of your base at all. Not for a while. There's a lot that comes.
Surrender to despair. The eclipse.
There's just way too much to deal with right now, so we're gonna kind of leave it alone. And there we go. Last research, and we're good to go. No life gain. As I said, absolutely no Terran research whatsoever. It's, it kind of sucks. But that's why you do it now. It's because you get all these researches when we go back into the actual campaign, and we're going to have such an easy time. No. Okay, he took a bit of a hit because I was trying to bring him away in the wrong direction. And now he's hitting that one. Okay. Easy. Uh-oh. Okay, good stuff. My doom is only delayed though, so it's a bit of a problem. Alright, they got them too. So try and keep the cannons up. Not a huge deal if they go down. They're not an integral part of your defense. Right now, we're only focused on building. He always has 800-800, and you'll know when he levels up when he has more health, and that gives him a couple of abilities to use, which kind of suck for you, but what can you do? Nothing. And you can save it at crucial points where you do have a lot of units, because you don't quite know when they'll attack your base, which is kind of a problem. And it really sucks if they do a coordinated attack with the hybrid, but usually that doesn't happen. Immortals against him are useless. He's only massive and biological. Now, I'm not really doing that strategy anymore with the whole... Yeah, he's still attacking that guy. All dead. Creepy as hell. Alright. I think I can push out just a little bit. If not, then I guess I'll pull back really fast. You gotta keep your eye on the map. I can toggle the colors. No, I can't. Never mind.
Some secrets must remain
Alright, let's pull back a little bit, let them come after me. He's coming though, so we're gonna have to bugger off a bit. Let's go right here. And he's coming that way now. Generally, wait, let's see how much health. Okay, there you go. He's just leveled up. He's gonna have probably new ability right now, just to stun our guys. And that's pretty much what he gains. Yeah, there you go. No, don't fucking follow him. Oh, not a huge deal if you lose the Dark Templar. They're probably the less... He's probably the least useful of everything, so, you know, I don't shed a tear if the Dark Templars die. Although it's nice to have them. They do a fair bit of damage. It's still better to have the Stalkers. We'll go do another one there. It's just gonna be our little pylon farm in the back. Alright. What you can do is, before you exit, just do a quick save. Oh, there we go. Alright, and he's coming back again, so we actually can't leave. We really want to get that base in the bottom because of that Templar's Archive. We're trying to get all the research, and it's more than possible. You just gotta kind of get lucky with a good opening and a good amount of units. Let me go make two more pylons here. And go back. I can't quite see what's a micro. It's okay, you went to the other side here. Done. Already. Nah, you go to get your ass kicked. Uh-oh. There you go, that's what I was worried about. There you go. You don't want it to die, you want to keep your options open, so... Alright, let's try and go do that our attack again. They don't attack that one, just this one. I don't know why they attack that one. I don't think you lose the research, but it's still one of those things. There you go. And a few more. Oh, tried to bring that guy back. Failed miserably. Also do remember to focus down everything here. I'm gonna have this guy attack those guys. I cannot micro him. There you go. And just take out the pylons, and the rest of these will go down really, really easily. And we're done already. Alright. Bring a probe down. And just build a couple more guys, okay. You can also build another base here. I save that for a little later, because right now I have enough to keep these guys busy. And head back up.
This Templar archive lies abandoned. Is the void.
And at this point, I'm just saving, because I don't want to have too much of a problem. Oh, dear God, not more lag. There we go.
I am the voice of the eclipse.
I'm probably going to have to wipe my machine or something and get that fixed.
I am the...
There we go, we got ourselves this.
Ready yourself, noble warrior. We confront a terrible evil this day.
Now, my whole thing with Templar is, in this mission, it's only really good to use for using feedback on this guy, and that's it. You do have Psystorm, but there is... I don't think there's really any point where it's technically that useful, so I usually just avoid it. At this point, I'm just trying to get more Stalkers, and then we're going to be done this. Oh.
Your resistance ends this day.
Literally, that is only the only thing you should be doing with this guy. Because the thing is, when you bring him down here, there's actually a bunch of Templar. I don't even know what the hell they are, but it's really difficult to keep them all alive. Because then they get feedbacked and all that kind of stuff. It's not worth it. The one is fine. You don't need any more than that. If you really want, you can try. I've just never had much success with them. I always found them to be a waste of money. Alright, we can get another thing down here. Be back. There you go. And he's done. So the guy isn't that hard. You just have to have like a large amount of forces to pretty much take him down. Which, you know, kind of says that he's hard, but it's whatever you want it to be.
You have not enough minerals.
And we need kind of a little bit more minerals, so that's why I'm kind of building a bit more probes, because our mineral count... We could sustain 4 with the amount of gas I have. I just have it maxed out on minerals right now. There we go.
You have not enough minerals.
Usually I'm running out of gas.
Some secrets must remain hidden.
I'll never get over how creepy he is.
You have not
I should probably just get rid of that. I like to go out with not max supply, but near it.
You have not enough minerals.
There you go. We have to start building a few more pylons, though. Come on. Feed the pylon farm. And there you go. He doesn't even take down a single unit, though. Alright, we're gonna go start heading down here, then. They're kind of going their own separate way. I'm hoping that it won't get them killed, but it might, so... And our Templar's following, so we're good. Okay. And once again, our very favorite Void Ray. Shot down in an instant. It's still a huge problem. So we just wait for him to come here. Hey, buddy. Look at that. Just taking them all down. And that one immortal is still alive. See what I mean? Stalkers kick ass. Okay, we can try it now. In the end, you don't have to actually take out anything. What you can do is you can just make a run past. Here, just watch this. Watch this pro shit. Maybe not. I don't know. I'm going to just do this try.
Of the preservers are entombed within. We must break them open immediately.
There you go. See, that's why I have blink stalkers. So, you know, you probably didn't need this much, because it doesn't really matter that you didn't kill everything here. That's like one of the bonus objectives.
Very well.
Oh, look, okay, we win. That's it. No penalties for that.
We have seen prophetic fragments in your mind, Seratum. We will make of them what we can.
So, all objectives, all researches, very good.
The cycle shall draw to its end. The Zelnago who forged the stars will transcend their creation. Yet the fallen one shall remain, destined to cover the void in shadow. It begins with the great hunger. It ends in utter darkness. A great hungerer. Could it refer to the Zerg Overmind? It has a part to play in this prophecy. I must seek out the Overmind's final resting place. Our ancient homeworld of Ire.
That's it. I even finished under 25 minutes, which is really good. It didn't kill all the protoss, obviously. I just skipped them at the end there, but, you know, that's pretty much all you do to it. It's pretty simple. I only lost 35 units. I'm guessing most of that's at the end, too. So that one's not too difficult. Next one, not too difficult either, if I recall, for the protoss. And the last one is a pain in the ass. But, you know, maybe I'll find a good strategy I can tell you guys. I remember it being a pain in the ass. It was the one I couldn't do, like, without, like, you know, I'll tell you more about that later.
I don't think your buddy Horna likes me very much. I'll drink to that.
Level 800 Elite Tauren Chieftain is back with a new album, pulse-pounding rock that will shake the galaxy. Rock out with such hits as Rogues Do It From Behind, Terran Up the Night, Another Hydralisk Bites the Dust, Saturday Night's Alright for Nuking, Lucy in the Sky with Mutus, Every Rose Has Its Thorn, Touring in Your Galaxy, No!
Quite possibly the best thing. I think I missed that. What is that? Friend of the Protoss. Oh, it's for what I got for Haven. Huh.
You look spooked. You've been seeing what the Protoss has to show ya. The memories shine through ya as clear as day.
I saw a hybrid. Something unnatural. It was trying to corrupt the Protoss preservers. Who would have sent it there? Who controls something like that?
The one that made them, for sure. That was just the first of many. Dark harbingers, man. Soon they'll be beyond numbering. And the stars will weep at what comes after.
How could you know all this?
I don't. I just feel it be true.
Okay. To the bridge.
Welcome back, sir. What did you discover from the crystal this time?
It's that obvious I used it, huh? Zeratul took the prophecy fragments he found to a temple? Library? Kind of both, I guess. But this weird Protoss-Zerg hybrid had taken over the place.
You mean some sort of infested Protoss?
No, this wasn't like infestation at all. It was like someone took the strengths of both races and twisted them together. I gotta tell you, if these things are real, we're in a lot of trouble.
Oh, wow. Okay, I guess we'll go to the armory briefly.
What's up, cowboy? You know, you're looking kind of rough lately. Rougher than usual, I mean.
I've, got a lot going on right now, Swan. You know how it is.
Yeah, sure. You know, you might want to try laying off the sauce and getting some shut-eye once in a while, huh?
Thanks, Mom. I'll get right on that.
It's... the armory has something new, but we're going to actually save that until I'm done all the Protoss stuff. Because I don't know how much money I'm going to have by the end of that. I know nothing I get there is going to benefit me. But I'll get the laboratory stuff anyways, just because... So we got a new thing in both trees, which is really nice. Oh, it's so good. Okay, first of all, you get either regenerating ship and vehicles slowly regenerate life, which is, this is what I chose the first time I played this, because, you know, it sounded better than this one. You start with plus 100 energy, and they gain 100 bonus energy, which is... You know, this is actually fantastic for some of the units you get later on as well. Definitely pick this. This is completely pointless. There's no point in doing this. And there's a good reason why you don't even do this. And I'll just tell you now, the science vessel will repair your units for you. And plus, with this, you get 100 energy on them. And they do it so much faster. So don't bother. Get this one. Look how I'm, like, alternating. That's kind of cool. I think I'm gonna be breaking it, though. I'm not sure. Anyways, so the second one here is, you can train two SCVs at the same time to quickly get all your minerals and stuff like that. Or, you can get an automated refinery, which is basically they. It warps. There's no SCVs going between a command center and here. It's just this one. Now I'm going to tell you basically the pros and cons of each one. This one I originally got for my first run because it kind of sounded better. I'm like, well, you know, you're going to get more SCVs that way, so more you'll get more minerals and eventually more gas. However, there's one really really short-sighted thing I didn't quite take into account, which is when you have this, you get the gas mining right away without the need for SCVs, so you will have a nice gas stockpile pretty early in the game. And there's another advantage, which is basically if you're short on gas but you want to, let's say, take over and expose gas, you can do that without having a command center there. Or you can just have it wherever on the map, like whenever you take over an enemy base or something, just build a geyser, okay? And you get like unlimited gas basically this way. You basically remove the need for gas. Almost. Definitely take that. I've done another playthrough where I use these. They were so much better and more worthwhile. Was not even a joke. So that's basically it for now. I guess we'll just read into some more of the stuff here. It's the energy crystal. By the way, these are Stepman's logs, if you haven't noticed. Kind of interesting. He wants to play Lost Viking too. And this is the other one, the Zerg. The Zerg is, has a large neocortex. Damn, that's creepy. Okay. I guess that's it for now. We'll do the rest later, so goodbye.